Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, we're going to be learning a lot of new vocabulary and terms related to a type of line called a transversal. This is the first of two lessons about transversals. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to identify the special angle pairs created when a pair of lines are cut by a transversal. First, we'll define and identify a transversal. Next, we'll define and identify all special angle pairs created by transversals. Finally, we'll complete one big practice problem. I've been using the word transversal a lot, but chances are this is a new word for you. A transversal line is a line that intersects any two or more other lines. Mathematicians will often shorten the term transversal line to just transversal, like I've been already doing in this lesson. In our diagram here, this line would be a transversal because it's intersecting these two lines. We could draw infinitely many examples of transversals that go through these two lines. These are just a few of the different possibilities. Transversals can cross any kind of lines, but as you may have guessed, we'll mostly be talking about what happens when they cross parallel lines in this unit. When two lines are intersected or cut by a transversal, there are eight different angles that are created by the intersections. Try to find all eight angles in this diagram. Now, count them up. Did you find all eight? Each of these labels is at the vertex of its angle. Let me show you an example. Number one is representing this angle right here. Number two is representing this angle right here, and so on. We're about to learn a set of specific vocabulary terms related to these angles, but to start with, the angles are broken into two main categories: interior angles and exterior angles. Using your decoding skills, make a prediction about how our diagram might be separated into these two categories. Exterior, with that prefix x, is going to refer to the angles on the outside of our two non-transversal lines. Four of these angles are exterior. Can you tell which ones? These four, 1, 2, 7, and 8, are our exterior angles. That means that 3, 4, 5, and 6 would be our interior angles because they are inside the non-transversal lines. If this is a little tricky for you to visualize the inside and outside of this diagram, that's okay. This is a new concept and it'll take some practice to get used to it. One trick that you might want to use is to think of our diagram like a sandwich. My favorite sandwich is a cheeseburger, so that's what I'll use. Each of the non-transversal lines creates the buns, and these represent the exterior. In between the non-transversal lines is all the good stuff. The patty, the cheese, maybe some lettuce, tomato, a little ketchup. All these meat and toppings are the interior of the sandwich. Here's a new diagram for us. So far, you've been using two capital letters representing points with a line on top to create notation for lines. Another common way that you may see lines labeled is with a lowercase, usually cursive letter at the end of the line or segment in a diagram. In this case, we just say, for example, line M, and we don't need any other notation. So here we have line M, line N, and line A. Which of these lines is the transversal? Line M. Well done. Line M intersects both line A and line N, which makes it a transversal. Let's go ahead and label all eight angles that have been created here again. There is no particular order that you have to label them in. The labels are just there to give us an easy way to refer to the angles. Let's talk about the special pair created from our exterior angles first. Which of these angles are exterior? If I imagine my hamburger buns, they would be on angles 1, 2, 7, and 8. The pair of angles we're going to discuss here are called alternate exterior angles. Try using your decoding skills. Can you guess one pair of angles that are alternate exterior angles? The definition for alternate exterior angles is two exterior angles that are on opposite sides of the transversal. The alternate exterior angle pairs are 1 and 8 and 2 and 7, since in each pair, both angles are exterior but on different sides of the transversal. Next, let's talk about our interior angles. Imagine all the meat and the cheese inside that hamburger. Which angles are our interior angles? Those would be angles 3, 4, 5, and 6. First up are alternate interior angles. Check out this definition and compare it to the definition for alternate exterior angles that we just saw. There are two pairs of alternate interior angles here. Can you identify both pairs? If you said angles 3 and 6, and angles 4 and 5, good job! These are the angle pairs that are on the interior and on opposite sides of the transversal. Next up is a pair called consecutive interior angles. Try to use context clues to make a prediction about what this angle pair might look like. Hopefully, you notice that we're still talking about interior angles, so it must only involve angles 3, 4, 5, and 6 again. Then there's consecutive. That word means in a row or following after. The official definition for consecutive interior angles is two interior angles that are on the same side of the transversal. That means that identifying these pairs is very similar to what we did on the last slide, but now we want those interior angles on the same side of the transversal. There are two pairs of consecutive interior angles in this diagram. Take a moment to identify both pairs. Did you guess angles 3 and 5 and angles 4 and 6? You're a pro. These pairs consist of interior angles that are both on the same side of the transversal as each other. Phew, there are a lot of angle pairs to talk about, and we have two more to go. Next up is corresponding angles. These pairs are a little bit different. Have you noticed that our transversal creates an intersection on each line? Let's get rid of these four angle labels on the top. Do you see how if I just slide that bottom section along my transversal, it matches the intersection in the top part of the diagram? Corresponding angles are pairs that sit in the same corner or section of both intersections. Let's try to apply this with angle 8. Can you tell me which angle makes a corresponding pair with angle 8? Did you figure out that angle 8 corresponds with angle 4 because they're both in that sort of bottom corner of the intersection? Try to find the corresponding matches for the rest of the angles. Now, check your answers against mine. Last but not least are vertical angles. Vertical angles don't only exist in this situation of lines cut by a transversal. They exist any time you have two lines intersecting. Don't let the name fool you. In this case, vertical doesn't mean up and down. It refers to the vertex of angles. Vertical angles are the two angles on opposite sides of an intersection. The vertices touch in the middle, but they don't share any rays. In the highlighted example, angle 7 and angle 6 are a vertical angle pair. There are three more pairs of vertical angles in this diagram. So pause the video now and try your best to identify the other three. How'd you do? This diagram looks a little different than the one we've been working with so far, but everything works exactly the same way. We have two lines and a transversal that goes through them. So pause the video here and use your notes template PDF to identify all of the special angle pairs in this diagram. Don't worry, I'll still be here when you come back. For the alternate exterior angles, 1 and 8 are on opposite sides of the transversal, and so are 4 and 5. For the alternate interior angles, angles 2 and 7 are on opposite sides of the transversal and are part of that interior meat and cheese part of our burger. So are angles 3 and 6. The consecutive interior angles are still going to be within angles 2, 3, 6, and 7, but now the pairs are on the same side of the transversal. The corresponding angles are in the same corner of the intersections. So we have angles 1 and 3, 2 and 4, 5 and 7, and 6 and 8. The vertical angles share their vertex, but no rays. So they are across from each other in each intersection. Here we have angles 1 and 6, 2 and 5, 3 and 8, and 4 and 7. Now you can identify alternate exterior angles, alternate interior angles, consecutive interior angles, corresponding angles, and vertical angles. Next time, we'll start applying these concepts to calculations. See you next time!